Today, I'm in Thanet, Kent, and we're going to take a look into the forgotten underground tunnels of World War II. In the Second World War, a network of underground battle headquarters was established by the South East Army Command, with tunnels excavated at Tunbridge Wells, Canterbury and Reigate. There was also an underground brigade headquarters located in a disused quarry at Sarre. This was located on the Isle of Thanet in Kent. The area was fortified by the Canadians, who would help form the Defence Force, if needed, to reinforce South East Command forces in the event of an invasion. The brigade headquarters consisted of three parallel stairways cut into a disused chalk quarry face. These descended 50 feet into a small complex of tunnels and rooms. This was possibly the original main entrance to the bunker, all reinforced with corrugated steel lining.
That's a load there.
Back to Sarre, underground brigade headquarters. In Sarre, as a matter of fact. Oh, it's a bit difficult. Yeah, it's awkward that. We're in. Cool. It's all burning actually from that light. What an entrance.
At the bottom of the stairs we head into a long room. This is reinforced with corrugated steel. From this room we head to the main part of the bunker. This section of the bunker, there lie four identical rooms with one smaller room at the far end. There are pipes that ascend vertically in the main corridor and in some of the rooms. These would have been used to carry cables to the surface. There is some graffiti in places. One seems to be dated 1930. That seems strange, as these tunnels are meant to be dated from the Second World War. There is a plaque set into concrete, possibly from the tunnelers, with numbers and dates. These rooms have brick walls and flat roofs. The roofs had steel girders across them, supporting it. This was not a very strong design in my opinion. Most of the underground bunkers in the UK were protected with rounded corrugated steel to spread out the weight. Unfortunately, this location has suffered small cliff falls in the locations and is very unsafe. This is a fantastic little location with a nice bit of history. Today the bunker has been sealed by the landowner and now lies like a time capsule for our future generations to come.
Hardest thing about Sarre is getting out.